I don't remember my childhood. I mean, I can remember the facts and can recall specific events if they ever brought up in conversation, but a large majority of my formative years are just a blank blur. And the weirdest thing is I don't know if it's a song. Welcome to Adult Life. As a kid, like many, I had dreams of becoming a YouTuber. But editing Minecraft shorts for 18-year-olds wasn't exactly what I had in mind. I don't get it. This used to be my dream. But now I wake up and dread having to edit another Minecraft video about talking sheep. What you doing? He's clearly talking straight. I used to have a passion to create when I was a kid, and I don't know where it's gone. Maybe I just need to get away for a couple of days. When I was 5 years old, my family moved to a farm in the Australian country. And as a kid, this complete change of lifestyle was equally exciting and terrifying. But as I got older, I missed the city, where I didn't have to travel an hour and a half to go to the movies, where my neighbours weren't 5 kilometres away, where people made YouTube videos.
This is my childhood bedroom that has now become a sort of dumping ground.
I just found this book of all these CDs. The last couple of days out here has really changed my perspective on this place. I always used to reflect and look at my time living out on this farm and see it negatively, as if I was missing out on something by being here. I always used to felt like hanging out with friends or going to a shopping mall was such a big event that excited me so much, and that living on this farm deprived me of being able to do that. And I just thought if I could move to the city that I would be able to do that whenever. But now looking back, I see all the things that I was actually able to do out here, like driving a car at 10 years old, or being able to play footy on a backyard that's as big as an actual football field. Oh, there's a dead mouse. Ew. These are things that not many other people got to experience, and they were everyday joys of my life that I never really acknowledged. So even though my mind in the moment was constantly focused about what could be, I wasn't acknowledging what was happening. And I think that's something that I want to take forward a lot in my life from now on. And instead of dreaming about where I could be or what I could have done, just acknowledge and love what I'm doing right now. Yeah. I'm fine. My God. And also watching all these home videos has really made me appreciate just having a camera there. I mean, if it wasn't for my grandparents filming all of this, there's no way I'd remember any of this. And having a camera around at such a young age was one of the main reasons I got into filmmaking. I mean, in like 10, 20 years time, I'm definitely not gonna remember half of this. It really makes me just wanna film more of my life now. It's so different and freeing being out here because I can yell,
and no one can hear me!
Which is not exactly something I can do in my apartment. At home, when I'm locked in my room, everything feels so compressed and there's so much stress going on that it's very hard to escape. And then as soon as I come out here, it all just goes away. I don't know if it's the open spaces or the rotting animal carcasses, but everything just feels a lot slower out here. There's not as much stress being in my office, constantly working, where everything feels so cramped. I don't know if you can tell, but it's a little windy.
It's been raining for the past couple of days, but now all the storm clouds are finally leaving, and I got this nice golden sunset.
Now the thing about these videos is, they're not exactly cinematic masterpieces. I mean, what do you expect from a 60-year-old discovering iMovie for the first time? But I can fix this. I can make this so much better.
Thing I know, it's only change.